excited to share an old story, familiar and dearly loved. Yet somehow every year the wonder of it all becomes new once more. Our hearts are stirred to celebrate, to sing, to repeat the sounding joy. We find ourselves wanting to say to all who will listen, pay attention, there's something in the air. It's both a whisper from the past and a song of hope for eternity.
Here for the rest of their lives.
Hey, Lord.
There was no room in the inn, no room for heaven's amazing gift of love, no room for the long-awaited Messiah, no room for our only hope of salvation, no room. Time and again, these two simple words stir our hearts, and we vow to make sure it never happens with us. Our prayer becomes, Father, don't let me fill Christmas with anything but who Jesus is and the reason he came the way he did.
Yeah.
shepherds worshiped when they found him in the manger. And he is the one we worship today. Amen.
Roaring angels gave the sign. How to babe on bended knee. The Savior of humanity. And to us a child is born. He shall reign forevermore.
Born a Savior, though I
2:17-18 says, after the shepherds had seen him, they told everyone. They reported what the angel had said about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. And just like those shepherds, once we find Jesus, once we understand the incredible gift we've been given, we can't keep it to ourselves. This is good news we have to share. It's Christmas. Jesus has come.